I'll tell you, we need more hawks. I was sitting by the ferry yesterday just eating an ice cream cone, and there was pigeons all over me. A little piece of the ice cream, like the cone part, dropped.
Yeah.
And like 80 pigeons went at it, and they were all around me. It looked like that movie The Birds.
Yeah, pigeons are rats with wings, as everyone knows.
Oh, it was gross. I had to run from them, like Tippi Hedren.
Yeah, I don't get a good feeling about those pigeons.
They're up to something.
Yeah, they look dirty, you know?
Nah.
I mean, I'm sure I don't look clean to them, but...
I just can't believe you were eating an ice cream cone after all the cookies and donuts you ate in here all morning.
Oh, dude, that's my thing. The ferry has these little ice cream, you know, like bars. Like, you know, like good humor.
Yeah, yeah.
With almonds in them. Oh, man, it's so good.
So... Like yesterday, you ate a lot in here.
I did. I ran down to Manja, too, yesterday. You know, that little deli there?
Let me understand what you did. So, in the morning, I saw you eating donuts, because I think there were donuts here.
Right.
And then you were eating some of those...
Krispy Kremes.
And the cookies.
And then, yeah, they had the shortbread cookies with almonds.
Right.
Yeah, I finished those off. Those
plus, you
well, how much of this are we talking? He's not taking a donut.
No,
I had one donut, you know, like one of those Krispy Kremes with the chocolate swirl, but I had two buttered bagels.
Right, I saw you eating those.
Throughout the course of the morning.
And I'm not sure there wasn't more food going on.
About three cups of coffee.
Yeah.
And
the cookies.
Munchkins throughout the morning.
Right.
That's like a sprinkling throughout the morning.
Uh-huh.
Like how many munchkins? Like 12?
No.
Yeah, come on.
An average morning, I probably eat like 8 or 9 of them.
All right.
I wasn't
that far off.
If Tom brings them in.
Right.
And then I left here and had lunch. I had a roast beef and Swiss sandwich.
Yeah.
And then when I got to the ferry, I had the ice cream.
Chocolate ice cream? With a cone?
Chocolate ice cream.
No.
But what did you get from Manja? The bagels?
No, Manja was, I got mozzarella and tomatoes.
Forgot that.
When did you eat that?
In the morning.
Oh, here.
Yesterday, though, was an extraordinary day. I ate a lot.
There couldn't be any more of a fattening day than that. Krispy
Kreme. You know,
cream.
Like the fresh mozzarella.
But that crap's got tons of calories.
Oh, yeah, so I had some of that.
Wow. Boy, you're talking, let's see. You've got to have consumed about 4,000 calories just in the morning.
That many, you think?
I think so.
Well, you know why? Because the mozzarella had oil on it.
Yeah.
And then what I did was, then I went home and I read. I have a new thing now. You got me into the New York Times. I try to read the New York Times.
Yeah, it's great.
I read all the other papers here. I go to Starbucks by me, get a caramel macchiato. And they have a holiday cookie.
Do you read the paper in Starbucks, like one of those loads that sit there all day?
No, I don't like doing that.
That's gay.
I like going up to my apartment and read it. Because what I do is I throw the sports station on and I have that in the background.
Who are these dudes that open up a computer and they move into Starbucks?
There are full offices going on there.
I mean, they got cell phone, computer out.
And these people talk loud about business on their cell phones. And there's always some hot chick student in there.
Right.
And they try to talk loud enough to where she hears
She gets interested. Instead of going over and saying, hey, how you doing, honey? Let me have some.
Yeah.
They talk real loud, try to be cool.
I know. Yesterday, I'm waiting online for my macchiato. There's a guy in the corner. He's got the earpiece in, the computer out, and, like, papers around. And he's going, I told him the proposal would not work. He's yelling into the phone.
You know there's no one on the other end of that phone.
He kept saying proposal.
Yeah.
And there was this smoking hot, like, Indian chick, like Middle Eastern Indian type chick.
Yeah, trying to attract her.
Oh, man, she was cute, but...
I'm powerful.
Yeah.
If you only knew the business I was up to here at Starbucks.
And then I realized what I look like. I look homeless.
And you know those guys, you know, if they really had something going on, they'd have an office to go to and start...
Yeah, they're probably unemployed.
No.
I'm like, what are you guys doing? So I...
Proposal.
He had a proposal. It wasn't working.
Yeah. He was probably like proposing. God knows what he was proposing.
He was proposing to a woman with some money.
Yeah.
And she wouldn't take him.
Yeah. I felt like going over to him looking like I look. And I go, dude, I bet I make more money than you.
You probably do.
We start fighting over this girl.
Yeah, yeah. That Indian chick is mine.
I wanted to hear my proposal.
They have holiday cookies now. You know those painted cookies with the...
The scenes on them?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And did you get one of those?
One of those.
Yeah, wow.
Yesterday was bad.
Yeah.
With the macchiato.
Yeah.
And then what'd you have for dinner?
And the macchiato. And then for dinner...
You'd think after all that you would skip dinner.
I have a neighbor, this woman, Helen, who is a saint. She makes me Greek lasagna.
Mm.
Like once every 2 months. She's a big fan of the show.
Right.
And I'll come home sometimes and my doorman will have a huge plate of lasagna, like a platter, because Helen left this for you. And I take it upstairs, and I just, I heat that up throughout the week.
Wow.
I had a nice big lasagna and the...
Holy mackerel, with cheese and the whole thing.
And there was a lot of college basketball's heating up. I watched the college basketball game.
How much of the lasagna do you eat? Like, do you eat the whole tray? Come on, be honest.
No, I don't eat the whole tray. It's a huge tray.
Yeah.
I don't
so, like, what portion do you is a meal to you?
You don't take a little square and...
I take, like...
Half of it.
You know, like, I go right down the line. Like, right. Probably, like, a double portion would be from most. Yeah.
A double hearty portion.
Yeah.
Well, you're a hearty guy. God, that's a lot of food.
And
man.
Then I had a black and white cookie.
And I don't hear one...
Another black and white cookie.
For dinner, black and white. But I had a holiday cookie before that.
Wow. There's not one vegetable, though.
No.
Not one salad, not one...
Nothing.
I like a little salad.
But you didn't have one.
But someone's got to make it for me. Like, if Dana's over, she'll make a salad. Like, you know.
He'll eat it if it's there.
Sometimes my mother will leave a salad for the week, and I just, you know.
You're like a little kid, man.
Everybody's cooking for him.
I am. I'm like a little... I never grew up.
There's no more infantile arty than when he's loaded, and they have to wheel him around in a wheelchair like it's a baby carriage, and then he's holding his bottle.
I always tell... Sometimes if me and Dana have arguments, I go, you got to realize something. You're not talking to a grown-up.
Oh.
I did not grow up.
Yeah. Try to argue on a sixth grade level.
Exactly.
You know, it's funny because like 2 weeks ago, Artie gave me these amazing steaks the Peter Luger Steakhouse sent to him. And I'm walking in the hallway and Artie goes, you want some steaks? And I go, those are amazing steaks. Why don't you take them? He goes, I got to cook them and stuff.
Right.
Like, he doesn't want to cook at all.
Well,
I understand that.
I know. I mean, you know, I'm a bachelor. I eat out, you know.
Do you ever cook?
Never in my life, no.
Bobo, you're on the air.
Hey, Artie, you know I love you, man, but you sound like a walking time bomb. What's your cholesterol, man?
What's my what?
What's your cholesterol? Do you ever have it checked?
I had it checked a few years ago, yeah.
A few years ago?
I said to Artie on the air, let's, like, have a doctor come in.
I don't want to do that.
And do your cholesterol and, you know, like your blood pressure and stuff. And he goes, I'm not doing that.
No, my blood pressure's perfect.
He'll do almost anything, but the cholesterol thing, he turned hands down.
I really don't want to know what it is.
Yeah, that freaks him out.
Yeah.
I mean, you never have soy or, you know, like green tea and stuff like that?
No, I'm not a fruit, Bobo.
No, not a fruit.
He's not gay.
He's healthy, man.
Yeah, I guess I'm gay. I'll have soy.
He's not Mr. Gay Universe.
So what is soy? What is that?
Soy is great, right, Howard?
I have soy milk.
Yeah, absolutely.
Soy milk.
Yeah, I love it.
I like half and half.
Yeah, more than milk.
Half and half is like not even...
Cream and milk.
And chemicals.
Right.
Hey, Artie, when was the last time you went to the gym? Like, do you work out or something?
Hold yeah, but believe it or not, I do with this iPod. I go down and I try to jog every once in a while. I break a sweat. I just go to, like, break a nice sweat, you know? I don't have any particular goal time.
And how long does that take?
Like 4 minutes? No, I can go about 2 miles. I can go about 2 miles.
Yeah?
Yeah, sure, on a good day. Yeah.
I don't know if you noticed, but I saw Artie in the hallway yesterday, and I said, have you lost weight? And Artie goes, yeah, I'm down 20 pounds. And I said, what are you doing? He goes, it's all about the iPod, man. I just get on the treadmill and go. But he lost 20 pounds.
But he has. He actually looks thinner.
He's amazing.
He's going to drop dead from something.
Well, here's what happened. See, yesterday I had an extraordinary eating day. With this schedule... Yeah, you can use it to your advantage by... Sometimes you can fall asleep before you eat because you're so tired.
Right.
And that's what I do sometimes. Like, the last time I'll eat is 2 in the afternoon, and then I sleep before I eat. Yes. I'm doing great.
Yes, Captain.
Hey, Artie, I got a question, and I'm being serious.
Yeah.
How do you maintain a girlfriend eating that much? I mean, is it because you're famous, or...
Yes, Jax, it's because I'm enormously famous.
No, well, I'm serious because, I mean, it's like, you know... You do eat a lot. I mean...
What
he's hungry.
How do I maintain a girlfriend? I don't know.
Well, because I mean, I've noticed in my life that, you know...
Jenks hasn't gotten up to the part of getting a girlfriend. So
he's
just
trying to... Exactly. How the eating gets
Artie, he's not putting you down. He's just trying to figure out how to get a girlfriend.
I'm not putting you down. I'm not putting you down. I'm just saying that you do eat a lot. And I mean, it's like...
Jenks wants to know, does he have to get famous?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. That's your answer.
That's the move,
he maintains a woman because he's famous.
Janks, let me tell you something. You could get laid off being Captain Janks.
Well, I tried. It doesn't work.
Oh, really? I'm sorry.
Believe me, I tried.
Well, then I'd start eating.
Girls don't want to sleep with Captain Janks? I don't get it.
Hey, you should put me on dial-a-date, Howard. I've been on the show 15 years, and you can't put me on dial-a-date?
When's the last time I did a dial-a-date?
When was the last time I got laid?
Hey, you know what? Say you'll put him on dial-a-date the next time you do it.
Next time I do it, you're on.
No.
Yeah, that's, you know what? I got to learn how to handle people. All right, thank you.
Thanks.